The progressive side of politics always has a bigger task. We have to inspire in order to get change. We don't just frighten people, we don't just prevent change. We have to inspire in order to create change. And sometimes we do it well and other times we do it less well. But ideas are the lifeblood of progressive change. I think politics is always more than political parties. It's always more than who stands for parliament. It's fundamentally about what you believe, what sort of community you believe we should have. And we have to have many voices in that debate, particularly at a time where we see a federal government that's intent not only on removing or diminishing fairness in our society, but remaking the Federation, remaking Australia in ways which I think are not conducive to greater equality and greater freedom. I think it's the role of the Fabians has become increasingly important because we need to have those ideas, you know, we need to have that contest of views, and we need a very clear-eyed look at what are the challenges and what are the different ways in which we should respond to them. We've seen over recent years, whether it's on climate policy, on carbon pricing, on the minerals tax or on other areas of taxation, some very powerful voices which have drowned out the voices of others. I think you see it in the context of the changes that the government wants to make to the Racial Discrimination Act and the racial vilification provisions in that. You know, Andrew Bolt and the Institute of Public Affairs want changes. The vast majority of the community, particularly ethnic community organisations, don't want change. But to whom is the government listening?